Hello, boys.
Welcome to today's video, where again I will be telling you some more tips and tricks for the European War 6. Well, that rhymed quite nicely. Tips and tricks for European War 6. Oh, I should become a rapper. I totally shouldn't. So, for today's video, I thought, what could I do? Show you first? And I remembered that last time I told you to build grenadiers and militia mostly, but riflemen actually also can be quite useful. If you look at them, wait, where? So if now I build in here a rifleman, you can see decent attack, okay damage. But what's really nice at them that they have no obstacles, they can walk for anything, which is really useful. And compared to grenadiers, for example, they're not a lot worse. They are a little bit worse, obviously, but there's a cost less. But what's really useful at them is that they're real beasts at traveling distance. So if you have to grab these you're far away and can damage them with grenadiers, you should have some riflemen running around and grabbing them. As a second tip is that for the 1798 Netherlands conquest, the second tip is if you want to farm gold and farm metals, do this, the Netherlands 1798 conquest, and follow my instructions for it in the video. I'll link it down below. And if you then get enough medals, as here on top right you see you get some medals. And if you get all of the medals, you exchange all of them to these kind of medals, then you should go on the item store, and if you have any, sell them. So if you have any kind of these here on top right, which you have here unnecessary, sell them, and they give 3000 gold each. Very useful if you still need some extra gold. And after a while you'll have them all, and then it really makes sense to every time sell them, and then every conquest gives you quite a good amount of medals. As the next thing is, again, in the item store, sell unnecessary items. For example, I've got here the standard short sword, which gives battle ability by 10 points, and I just won't really use that because my items are just a lot better. So I will sell it. So you simply click on it, you can click on anything here, you click on it, and then you press on sell, and you get some nice gold. As a general tip, if you play Conquest, it often makes sense to choose a country which does really bad. Like in 1806 or in 1812, the Austrians, they always do super bad. So if you can choose them and you play them good, your whole faction will do a lot better, because usually they just die really fast. Or you choose a country which joins really late, like in 1798, if you choose Russia or the Ottomans, they join usually so late that if you retake them from the beginning, you have a much larger impact on the game. Now, this tip just has to be for people who don't know how to do this. You have to collect your rewards. So for example, in the USA campaign, on the bottom left you have a little trophy, and if you have these kind of amount of stars, you do collect the rewards on the... You press here where those medal achievements are right now, which I have. But you have to collect them, they give you so much medals and gold. And I just can't imagine people don't do it, but I just want to go sure. Do collect these rewards, you have these in every bigger campaign. And you also have them in the conquest. For every conquest, it's right here, here on the red little achievement icon. Do collect these for every single conquest, so you don't need to go on 17, you can go on 1806, then it's different ones, and 1812, again different ones. Do really collect these. I can't stress this enough. And next, bit of a more, how should I say, normal thing is, if you have stronger generals. For example, I've got in this conquest Wellesley here, and he is quite alone. And in a moment is still in decent health, but if he later is not anymore so in such decent health, you can just retreat him because he's got a healing item. So generals with healing items, run away with them, they'll soon return, and if you can, you just have to look for a temple, and they'll regen health super fast and in some rounds again be fully ready to go, and you don't want to lose these kind of generals. As the next big, big thing is situational awareness. So for example, in this conquest here, I am trying to also help the Americas while also helping the Brits. But you can't always do help everywhere. You have to pay attention to which fronts are doing bad and assist there. So here, for example, I also helped the Austrians quite a bit, so they are doing fine because I'm aiding them quite a bit. At least I'm trying to. Just try to help your allies where they are the weakest. Not that you then have to clean up the whole thing, because if you can keep an ally alive, it's so much better than if you let them die. As the next big step again is, I have heard this already sometimes, with people who do not use their princesses, you should give them the flowers that's what they're for, max them up, the really useful ones, oops, and really in critical situations. As like I now own Boston, if I could build a palace, which I don't have the money for, let's say I do it in London, just to show you. I again don't have a palace here. It doesn't matter. You just, if you have a palace here, if you already have one where it's like the same symbol as here, put a princess there, that can be super helpful. Also, yeah, just do it. Now, again, a general tip is, if people are beginning of the game, they just want to play Conquest, and Conquest is a lot of fun, but don't forget Campaign. Campaign is super useful. Just do the campaigns, and they can be sometimes quite hard. And if you're stuck somewhere, that right comes to my 10th tip, go on the European war boards. There are often some guides. You can either write a question yourself, or you can just just search on it, because often people write like guides and it's really helpful. You can just ask people, very friendly, and yeah, just try to do it like that if you're really stuck somewhere. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Join my Discord to talk with me, to chat with me. Subscribe, turn notifications, write a comment, do whatever, dance in a circle. I'm not sure if you want to do the last one, but the other ones are really helpful to me. I wish you a nice day and goodbye.